Mark was off for the first 3 days this week up to Dontine to get our in-house gears measured, the ones that were in the first prototype main rotor gearbox. The results are in and we are absolutely delighted with how it's coming together. Still room for improvement, but within this pile of metrology reports here, what we're seeing essentially is that all of our in-house planet gears, all of our in-house spur gears, all of our in-house bevel gears, and all of our splines are already hitting the tolerances that are typical for US helicopter manufacturers. So we're already in a position where with the equipment we've got on the shop floor, we can make your main rotor gearbox. So really, really pleased with that.
Fun fact, a human here is about 100 microns. We're trying to hit tolerances within 8. That gives you a bit of an idea of the magnitude of getting gears within tolerance. So how do you get gears within tolerance? I know we talked about it a few weeks ago, but I want to know the process of how you get within those tolerances. So that's what I want to find out today. You're welcome to join me, so come along and let's find out how we hit tolerances.
So Mark, obviously we're working within tight tolerances that we have to work to because we're in the aerospace industry. What are the things that have to go into achieving meeting the tolerances?
Okay, so some of the things that we've done is climate control for starters. So we find that when the temperature was high in the summer, for every 1 degree over the standard 20 degrees, we're looking at possibly 2 microns for every degree. So when we're touching 26, 27 degrees out there, we were looking at 8 to 10 microns plus.
So fluctuation when you brought it into?
Absolutely, when it's stabilized, when it come in here, got back to its standard temperature, we notice a dramatic drop in sizing.
Right.
The second thing we've done is fine-tune the machine. So basically the machines come out of Japan and they're good, they're set up well for general machining, because we're high accuracy, low tolerance, chasing microns, we've basically had to fine-tune the machine so it sits so close to the nominal that it can possibly get. Which is helping us.
And so we have to do that because each industry has different ranges of what is accepted.
Yeah, standard general tolerance in it, the machines would have been absolutely fine, but because we're low end chasing microns, we've had to tune the machine up, fine tune the machine, so it's absolutely spot on.
And are those the two main things, or is there anything else?
And also work holding. We've got the most high accurate, repeatable work holding device that you can get out there. So we're using that. So a combination of all those three factors have helped us achieve the tolerances we want to achieve.
You may have not thought about it, but it's actually not possible to make a part to the exact size that you want it. There's always going to be some error due to the limitations of the manufacturing process. When engineers make assemblies of parts, they must fit together and work properly. Given the nature of real manufacturing processes, it becomes necessary to set acceptable ranges for those parts to be manufactured within. This includes ranges for size, shape, and finish, so that in the end, the parts still fit properly together. Generally, engineers will make tolerances as big as they possibly can so that they have enough room to work within to make it as easy as possible to manufacture the parts necessary. A road surface is a great example of this. Let me explain why. If a road had a difference of 10 millimeters of height across the carriageway, it wouldn't matter, it would make no difference to the road users. This means that you can relax on the tolerances. Why? Because there's no need to make them tighter, it would just cost you more money and time. It can be more relaxed because it is not as important and essential to have those tolerances at a tighter level for this certain project. However, some applications require really, really tight tolerances just to work properly. An example of this would be if the gears in this car weren't manufactured accurately enough. It would mean that they wouldn't have proper contact and would mean that in the future they would have a premature failure. This is why things like gears, bearings, and other high-speed rotating components need to be so precise, within single-digit microns. It's because for them to work and function properly, they need to have these tight tolerances. And these are the tight tolerances that we are working with the HX50, and that is why we put so much emphasis on hitting tolerances and chasing microns, because it's what we need to do to produce the HX50 to the standard that we want.
The process of making gears within the single digit tolerance is not only a work of art, but a display of precision in the most perfect earthly form. What must be achieved for a state-of-the-art flying machine is perfection, from the most simple of gears to the most intricate spline. Each part is given equal attention because each holds its own essential role in the industrial ecosystem that the helicopter creates, one where beauty meets perfect functionality. All these factors are what go into the HX50 and its beautiful design, engineering, and manufacturing. Thank you.